choosing the Lakers?
A lot of things. I think one of the things that definitely was on my radar was the fact that Rob called was the first call. I think that matters. Obviously, I had Michigan and Dallas, you know, several other teams that are acquired as well, but we didn't come out of those two. Looking at the team setup and the ability to possibly come in and make an impact and try to help the team win the championship, being home, and childhood dream come true, there's a lot that kind of goes into that. But, really having a chance to help the team win. And like I said, it's a special place.
Whether it's Darvin or Rob, what have they told you about what your role will be for this team?
Get downhill, provide rim pressure. Point of attack defense, also wing defense, depending upon the lineups. Switchability there. Just come in, be aggressive, set a tone, play with high IQ. Remember, in this situation, it's about like plugging in more so than, dominating yourself, right? So that's the mentality.
So there was a moment on the Lakers social account posted that you would do something on Lockerman. They had the jersey there for him, too.
Yeah.
What was that like seeing your Lakers jersey?
Yeah, so actually the funny part, I was just telling Lakers social this, it really hit home, not so much when I saw the jersey with in the locker, but he had put it on and he was like running down the corridor and I was behind him and I was looking at Dinwiddie 26 and I was like, oh, man, it's real, you feel me? Like, and for your son to be the reason why you feel it's real, like, that was a really special moment.
How have you viewed the Lakers from afar? This year's coming off the Western Conference Finals appearance, yep. They win the in-season tournament. Since early December, haven't looked quite as good, but they're starting to kind of rise again. Just, what's your view of them as an outsider?
I mean, you kind of led me into that. I mean, essentially, you're seeing a team that when everything's on the line, they can rise to a level that no other team can get to. Obviously, won in-season tournament, have played big-time basketball the past several years. Obviously, sometimes it's hard to maintain that, throughout a whole season, but at the end of the day, they know how to win. That's what Every night, they're going to get somebody's best shot just because of the name that's on the front of the uniform, and then obviously you have arguably the greatest player of all time on the floor as well, so then a lot of people are going to give him, personally, their best shot as well.
Is there any story behind the contract bonus you're going to get if the Lakers win the championship?
Yeah, so in my last deal, there was a series of bonuses tied to winning and stuff like that. One of those being the dollar championship bonus. A lot of people thought it was kind of funny at the time because I signed to the Wizards. But me and Gushan basically made a deal that we were going to keep it in whatever deal I signed, if possible, going forward. And it's kind of like just a thing that me and him bond over. It's just that now I'm actually on a team that has championship aspirations. So people are like, why the hell would you do a dollar? But it has more so to do with the talent that's with me and my agent than anything actually monetary.
Spencer, you in Dallas. How do you think that experience will help you kind of fit in with ball dominant kind of guards, whether it's LeBron and Austin?
Yes. Luke is one of the best players, if not the best player to date that I've played with. He got us so many open looks. I thrived in catch and shoot situations in large part because of him. A lot of credit there. Like, being one of my specialties, but then also shooting like very open looks was great. I mean, obviously, I get to, like I said, but I can be the best player of all time. And if I'm in that position to catch you open shots, then I have time to calm myself down as I have throughout my career. And so, that'll definitely help me. Obviously, the thing that I haven't done well in my career is shoot, off the dribble contested, like poor shot quality threes. And in some situations, I've been forced to do some of that in higher percentage than good looks, right? And so it affected overall percentage and sometimes it comes to misnomer. So the better quality looks and the more good quality looks versus bad quality looks, I have the most confidence in being a big time shot maker for this team.
Well, Steve is going to need of us to put this outside of the field.
Just being 6'6", athletic, willing to do whatever it takes to win. Understand that obviously we got Brian, AD, and a lot of offensive load, and that's where they're going to need a lot of my effort. And so, I'm going to go out there and look at the
body. First off, Spencer, is this the welcome home cut? Because you got me nervous at first with the mustache.
Nah.
you know, basically it got to a point where my mom said, you know, come on now, you're going to be a Laker. Can you just at least clean it up? And I told her I wasn't cutting my hair off, but I promised her I'd clean it up. And if you know me, my mom has a lot of sway on some decisions that I make. So that's the inspiration for this.
And then two, the playmaking. You guys run it. They run a lot of high splits, guard-to-guard screens. Yep. Bron also is a role man sometimes. How do you feel like your playmaking can fit along with that? Because you've averaged like 6 assists over the last like couple of years too as well with your playmaking. Yep.
Low turnover guy. Pretty good with the assists and whatnot. And obviously, if somebody's open, I'm going to try to find it. Basically, when I'm playing basketball, I'm trying to look for the best play available for the first like about 16 seconds of the shot clock. And then if it gets underrated, it's kind of like all bets are off. Obviously, we hope to always have a good shot, good possession. And if that involves me passing, like I'm more than willing to do so.
You've always had a chip on your shoulder.
What is the significance? Do you still feel that way? I sat in the league, and what is the significance of this? Just kind of for you, for you, for your family. Oh, man. For my family, it's big time, right? Like, everybody in the house is Laker fans. I mean, obviously, like, cousins and people from high school, all that. Like, it's the whole nine, right? Like, my mom and dad, I pretty much cried. My mom, not my dad, but basically it was a very emotional moment for them, just from the fan standpoint. Sorry, what was the first part of that question? So for me, I mean, you gotta remember, like, when my high school career started, you know, it was up and down between JV and varsity. Then it was, you know, not being ranked high, even though I signed to a, you know, Pac-12 school. And then, you know, even after almost being Pac-12 freshman year, to Tony Roden, who had a very much better year than, very clearly better year than I did, so I'm second, but he deserved it. I'm not saying he didn't. You know, still wasn't, you know, super heralded. You know, by the time I got really kind of any type of notoriety or anything like that, it was my junior year, and going into my junior year, it was pretty much guaranteed that I was going to get drafted. I told my ACL. So, you know, then I had to be a second round pick and not play at Detroit, fight through that, get to Brooklyn, like, average 20 points a game, get ready to get paid again, tear my ACL again. You know what I'm saying? And so every time I've been met with different, you know, hardships. And right now, obviously, there was different things said about me on my exit and things like that. And so, you know, I'm accustomed to facing adversity and, you know, turning things around and staying focused and kind of looking down the gun barrel and still being able to do what you need to do.
On Friday, had you made up your mind by the time you got to the game?
No.
What was Friday like? What did you see?
I mean, that's a lot. I mean, it was like a 5.5-hour flight, and I spent most of that flight talking to, you know, my parents who were on the plane with me, one of my friends. So, you know, we were working through all the different pieces. We were like, okay, you know, if we get there and the vibe seems cool, and, you know, obviously got to talk to D-Lo, got to talk to Torian, got to talk to C. Wood, you know, people that I play with, Rui, you know, Rui's excitement to see me, that felt good. You know, just things of that nature, because obviously it's a new situation. Whereas, you know, I'll give y'all something funny that I told my people, because I'm fairly candid. The two situations kind of felt like this, right? Let's say you were a kid, you got your ass whooped by the bully. Dallas could have been like your mama being like, it's okay, baby, don't worry about it. Lakers are like, your dad, nah, you better go out there and fight till you win. You feel me? And I just felt like that was what I needed at the time. You feel me? So I'm a big believer in kind of doing what you need to do at whatever time it is. And so that's how I felt about it.
C-Wood wanted the credit for for bringing you here. So you brought up Rui, you brought up a lot of teammates. C-Wood wants the credit, but who are we giving the credit to? Was it a team? Was it a team thing?
How the hell are we going to give C-Wood the credit? Bro, what are we doing? Look, C-Wood was impactful. I'm giving the credit to Bron.
Thanks, my job.
Man, great on-ball defense, great defense overall, playmaking, shot making. Just another positive, productive spirit to our group. And he's going to acclimate himself really, really well, really soon. So I told him, don't worry about making mistakes. We'll help talk him through it. Had a good session today on the floor with all of his defensive breakdowns. But we're super duper excited to have him.
You mentioned his on-ball defense. Brooklyn asked him to do more of that this year. Did you see that in watching film, a leap from him?
Yeah, I just think with our system, you know, I'm careful not to judge anyone based on what they're doing somewhere else. I know what he's capable of doing. I know what we have around him, what we're able to put around him. And I think he's going to thrive. But, yeah, definitely. I think he's going to thrive.
He was a guy who had a lot of success as a catch-and-shoot player off of Luka Doncic. Are there similarities with the way you guys play offensively that he can get some really good catch-and-shoot stuff playing off of really good isolation players?
Catch-and-shoots, three drives. I mean, the attention that Bron and AD draws, like, anywhere from two and a half, four players at a time, surrounding those guys, trying to keep them out of the paint, off the rim. He's going to have more than his fair share of open shots.
I didn't see him complimenting Austin.
Again, just all three of those guys can play together. His size, he can guard bigger wings. So we have to finish a game with those three. He's definitely more than capable of doing that. We will look at some lineups with three of those guys, along with Bron and AD. But I think he compliments him well. You know, he can defend, he can pass, he can dribble, he can shoot.
From the moment you guys got his commitment on Saturday afternoon to tip off tomorrow night against the Pistons, what's the onboarding
process? I'm sorry for being a smart ass other night too, talking about
the barbecue.
Yeah, the barbecue. Yeah. I'm sorry.
I almost led with that question, but I'm sorry.
You're good.
You're good. From Saturday afternoon to Tuesday night, so how do you guys give him onboarding information to put him in the best position?
We spent a great day. He signed yesterday officially. And so we were up here. He and I sat down, had a film session together. Just wrote out a lot of our terminology on both sides of the ball on the board. Did a great individual workout with our coach, J.D. Dubois. And so, you know, again, you're not going to learn everything overnight. There's basic tenets to what we do that it'll make it easy. It'll be a smooth transition for
him. As a driver, just paint touches to doing that, just how important – how much do you see him doing that for you guys, and how important will that be?
We're going to encourage him to do that. Like, we just had a film session this morning on that very thing, paint attacks. So we're going to encourage him just like the rest of our guys. He's more than capable of doing it. Thank you.
Real quick, how's Max?
Max is doing well. He's day to day. So we'll just keep tracking him, and he's trending in a positive direction, though.
Do you think there's a chance he plays in either of these two games, or with the All-Star break, do you just kind of like...
Yeah, I doubt it very seriously. Yeah, I doubt it. Yeah.
Keep the momentum going and win your series.
Oh, it's very important. We build up the momentum. Against the loss of the Denver. Learning some things about ourselves. Closing the gap in his name. So, it's going to be two big games for us to, you know, not just, you know, moving up in the standards, but also going to All-Star. I mean, you know, to finish the, I guess, first half, I guess, of the season. You know, going to All-Star with two wins, it'll feel good where you're not waiting 7-8 days to play.
Eddie, what do you make of the Spencer signing? You obviously talked about him last game, but now that's official.
Yeah, man, like I said, we think he can help us. Another big guard, to score, to shoot, play make, defend. So, especially with all the guys that's out, you know, Vando and Cam, Gabe, you know, it brings another guard wing in for us to fill those spots until, you know, we have everybody get back and then figuring out rotations and things like that. But, so I think it's a really good signing for us.
Katie, it's been 2 years since you've been in All-Star. Was getting back into that mix did matter to you?
But you getting back means that you've achieved your goal of being available for your team. Because when you're on, basically, when you've been on the court in your career, you've been in All-Star.
Yeah, but I could have not made it still.
Maybe people thought you were deserving, perhaps.
Right. Does it mean something that the coaches voted you on rather than...
I mean, it's always an honor to be an All-Star for sure. But I don't play for All-Star selections, you know. really have no control like over that. Like I said, the time dog band has been great memories, great time, great fun. The last two that I didn't make, actually, the most fun I had, I was with my family. The days with my family. So this one is cool because it's close to home, you know, 3 hour drive. So you know, I get to see some more of my family. But it's always an honor to be an All-Star.
You got the years then, kind of up and down, a couple highs, and maybe one of those. But you guys won 9 of 14.
Does it feel like you guys have found something? It's a decent chunk of time. Does it feel like you guys have hit a stride of some kind?
In a sense, I mean, anytime you start to find something, that goes down, you know. So that's kind of been like our MO this year. But I think for the most part, as of late, I think the biggest change is we're just playing for each other, you know, guys sharing the basketball. We've been high in assists for the past like 3 weeks, month, you know, playing the right way and then letting the rest take care of itself. Usually when you play the right way, you know, lead to wins. You know, we had some tough losses, you know, Houston, Atlanta, but I think for the most part we played well against Denver. You know, so you're gonna, you know, even when you play well, you're gonna lose some games. But I think we are, you know, figuring it out on both ends of the floor. And like I said, add Spencer to that mix is gonna, you know, I think can help us bring him along. But we definitely figure something out.
As one of the leaders of this team, how can you help Spencer get up to speed?
Well, he's a very high IQ player. Man, even with a day like today, we were kind of just walking through some things. And I think for him, it's just, you know, different, you know, names for things, you know, different plays, different terminology. So once you get the terminology down, it'll be easy to transition. But he's been in the league for a long time. He's a vet, so he knows most of the calls. Like I said, just the terminology they probably get used to.
Hey, do you think this? You mentioned being high in the assist recently. Even with guys being in and out, is that just a reflection of guys understanding and knowing what's expected of them offensively, where to be, where to run to, things?
Yeah, I mean, we talk about our running habits, where we're supposed to run on the floor offensively. Guys being confident in making shots. Like I said, I think it's just a thing of playing the right way, playing together. And when you do that, you know, guys aren't hunting shots or, you know, oh, I have to shoot this one, you know, because you're not sure if you're going to come back to you. So playing the right way, playing together, you can pass up a good shot for a great shot, knowing that you might be on the other side of, you know, that shot where you get the shot and,
you mentioned after the loss to Denver that there were some things that needed to be cleaned up on kind of both sides of the court for you guys to really compete for a championship long term. What do you think are some of the priorities going into this All-Star break that you'd like to see on both sides of the court?
First off, we give us a chance for guys to heal, rest up, be healthy. You know, Cam, Max battling ankle. Yeah, lingering injuries that guys have that, you know, guys are playing for. When we've been healthy, we've been fine. So I think just, you know, two more games, obviously. Detroit's been playing well, despite their record. And then in a lot of games, they won their last two. They won their last two, right?
They just lost.
Okay, well, before that, I think they won two. But also, they've been playing well, and then actually Utah. A team that's played well all year, especially at home. So, you know, for us, it's, you know, taking it one game at a time for these last two, and then, you know, using the play to get healthy and come back ready to, you know, finish this last stretch.
Hey, last two.
You've been mentioning a lot about sharing the basketball today. I mean, the last four games, you averaged 6 assists. You have told Brian, like, yo, I play point guard too. I'll find you. Just talk a little bit about that for you in terms of, you know, showcasing that and then being that facilitator out there, averaging 6 assists in the last four.
You know, the teams are doubling me a lot more. So it's my job to create plays out of the double team for my teammates. And they're just taking my time reading the defense, you know, knowing who we're playing and what they like to do on double teams, see how they guard other guys. Joker and Embiid, because they probably going to double the same guy. So, you know, watching that tape and seeing what they're doing, just knowing, you know, where my guys are going to be and talking to them before the game, like, okay, this team has to come from the top. I want you here. I want you here. Putting guys in certain positions and just making reads from there.
Do you feel like
have you ever seen the West competitive 1 through 4 being so close that 7 through 10 playing?
It was a little bit like that last year, but this year is very, very close. It's just the nature of the league now. Everybody's competitive. Teams got good players. They're playing together, playing for each other. The basketball is at all-time high right now. Players are getting better and better. Coaches get better. The league is getting better. So it makes it more interesting. It makes it more fun. But now you got to go out and compete every game. Where it's like, okay, you can take this game off, or you going into wherever. I don't want to say the same name, but you go into an arena and you know you're going to get this win. Where now, can't necessarily say that. Yeah. Because things are.
Thanks, Eddie.
Appreciate it.